Jake Overgaard here, University of Minnesota Extension Educator, here today to talk to you a little bit about growing raspberries in a high tunnel. And so this is going to be very basic entry-level type information. First, I'm going to kind of cover why you might want to do so. Also discuss a little bit about cultivars and the options that are out there based on the research University of Minnesota has done. Also, we'll talk a little bit about spacing and layout in a high tunnel for planting of raspberries, and then a little bit on spotted wing drosophila, which is a relatively new insect pest for Minnesota growers that can be quite a challenge to deal with, and then finally some additional resources that you might take advantage of to learn a little bit more.
All right, now to get into a little bit more detail on growing raspberries in a high tunnel. The main reason why you would choose to grow raspberries in a high tunnel instead of out in the field is the yield. As you can see here, the solid lines are two varieties grown in a high tunnel versus those same varieties grown out in the field, represented by the dotted line, and there's really quite a big difference in the yield from both of those varieties. So that's kind of the kicker in terms of why you would want to do it. You can also see an improvement in quality as well, typically due to the fact that the plants and the berries are not exposed to elements. Mainly rain, which can lead to fungal issues and really reduce the quality of the berries. Also, the size of the berry it tends to be larger for those that were grown in a high tunnel. So those are some of the main advantages. Certainly, you have to weigh those against the cost of the high tunnel itself. These are important considerations to make. In terms of cultivars, U of M has looked at a number of different cultivars that are popular and rated them for different aspects of their quality, and also just given some general information about them, like when the harvest is. Included is the productivity, fruit size, attractiveness, firmness, flavor, freezing quality, vigor, and thorniness. So you can look at these and try and choose some of the best ones. And if you're first starting out on a piece of land, it could make a lot of sense to try to evaluate a few different varieties and see how they perform on your land. In terms of layout, you want to plant them using a north-south orientation. Typically, we recommend 6 to 10 feet between the rows, and then between plants we're looking at 18 inches between each plant. Also, we certainly want you to encourage you to use trellising. Pretty much couldn't do it without it. In a high tunnel, the plants typically are a lot more vigorous and will really grow quite well, and so providing some support is necessary. This graph just shows the yields at different spacings. So you can see that at a 12 and 18 inch spacing, those are the purple and green lines, yield quite similarly, and the 24 inch spacing is quite a bit lower. And so 18 inches is the recommendation, just because the yield is quite similar to 12 inch spacing. And by planting every 18 inches instead of 12, we can reduce the number of plants that we have to purchase and plant. So this is just a photo of raspberries in a high tunnel. You can see we've got some nice mulching going on in between the rows. Plants are trellised, growing quite well, and we've got a lot of berries on there as well. So looking good here. Just want to briefly mention one of the biggest challenges that we have right now for berry production in general in Minnesota, and definitely with raspberries is the spotted wing drosophila. It is a fruit fly. Typically fruit flies, we know fruit flies, and they go after overripe fruit or rotten fruit, something that's sitting in the garbage or has been on the ground for days and days. However, this particular fruit fly will go after ripening fruit. And so this is definitely not good for berry production in Minnesota. As you can see in the upper right-hand photo, there is a very small larvae crawling around in that raspberry, and that's just not a marketable berry. There are some management techniques that you can use. There's certainly some trapping that you can do. There are a number of different sprays that are available for both conventional and organic growers. But like I said, it is definitely a challenge, and I'll share some information with you on that management. Some people are starting to investigate the use of netting, and this can definitely be one of the tools in the management of spotted wing drosophila. I'm sharing a nice manual or publication from Michigan State that gives some recommendations for specifically for organic growers. And so, the additional information. We have a University of Minnesota has a high tunnel website, and that is the first one listed there, hightunnels.cfans.umn.edu. You can find out more about spotted wing drosophila at Fruit Edge website. That's the second bullet. And then the third one listed there, that's the publication from Michigan State that has management information specific to organic growers and discusses netting. And so just do a web search for that title and you will find it. So I hope this is helpful and kind of gets you started to think about growing raspberries in a high tunnel. Thanks.